It's Kathy of findingkathybrown.com, and it is now 2 weeks as a non-smoker. So how am I doing? I'm doing really well. I feel really good. I feel better than I have in a while. I breathe really good. I'm having more energy. So physically, I'm feeling a lot better. How am I doing mentally? Not so good. Not so good at all. I'm still having days where I'm thinking about a cigarette. I've gotten a lot of support from my YouTube family, from my cat. She does not like being on video. I just wanted to show her because she's pretty. but I've had some moments where I've questioned my quit. Questioned if I'm strong enough to do it, and it's been really difficult at times, but I'm making it through, and it's not going to be easy, because everything that I do in my life revolves around smoking, and it has since I've been 12 years old, and I'm pushing 50 now, so, you know, it's a long time to be a smoker, and you know, my other quits, I've quit for, you know, a couple months at a time and found a reason to go back to it. So I know I have to really be on top of things and just really work hard to be a non-smoker right now. And that's what I plan on doing. I got some really great advice on my comments on my last vlog, and it was just laugh really hard, laugh at everything. And so you know who you are. Left me that advice, and it's the best freaking advice that anybody has given me. So I try to just kind of laugh as much as possible and kind of laugh at myself sometimes. Like, you know, I'm a big baby, I am. It's just a cigarette. That's all it is. It's just a cigarette. You know, I'm addicted because the cigarette companies wanted me to be addicted. And because at 12, I wasn't mature enough to make a decision like that that was going to consume my whole life. And the deck was stacked against me in the first place, because I was being tricked and manipulated to think that smoking was a good thing. And everyone around me smoked, and, you know, it was supposed to be cool. I was fooled. I was manipulated at 12. Story about when Steve and I were driving home from Florida a few days ago. And it's kind of a silly story, but I'm going to tell it anyway. So we were listening to a classic rock station. And so if you're around my age, you know, you're too young, you probably have no idea what I'm talking about. But if you're close to my age, you remember Van Halen back in the day. You know, I used to be a big Van Halen fan. And a song came on the radio, and it was classic Van Halen. And you know what came to my mind? What came to my mind was their videos and how remember how Eddie Van Halen always had a cigarette hanging out of his mouth. And if it wasn't hanging out of his mouth, it was on the end of his guitar, like just sitting there burning, waiting for him to smoke it. And I never really thought about it until my quit and then that ride home, of how when I was younger, smoking was presented as the thing to do. It wasn't like it is today, where it's socially unacceptable. It was good to be a smoker, you know. And I don't ever remember being young and thinking about health risks, maybe because I was young and stupid. But there's really no excuse for me yet. So I'm on 2 weeks. I hope that you are traveling on this journey with me. And if you are a smoker, I hope that you will give it a try to quit. Subscribe to me, please. I'll t- take support from wherever I can get it, and I'll certainly give support to anybody who needs it. Just hang in there and have good days and bad days. Maybe you'll have no bad days. Maybe you'll just slide right through this thing. You never know unless you try, right? So I'll touch base with you again in a few days. And I hope everyone has a great Tuesday and doesn't smoke today.